Hello, a very good afternoon and welcome to what is a pretty damp, a pretty sodden Motegi. Saturday is qualifying day, but don't worry, the rain hasn't dampened our spirits whatsoever. Welcome to Inside the Paddock with me, Jack Appleyard, and we're going to speak to Lucio Cecchinello this afternoon. And not only is it Taka Nakagami, there we go, his home Grand Prix, but he's also fighting through the pain. Yesterday, I'm sure you might have seen the images either on the live at the end of free practice or on social media afterwards, in real discomfort, pulling off his glove, of course, as a result of the injuries caused by the clash with Marc Marquez on the opening lap of the Aragon Grand Prix just 6 days ago. He said yesterday his glove was full with blood at the end of that free practice session, but the warrior that he is has been declared fit, was out riding this morning and did 18 laps in these very testing conditions. So follow me and we'll go and have a chat with him. Also an opportunity to show you the paddock here in Japan, as well as we return for the first time since 2019, and things are slightly different here. Always whenever we come outside of Europe, obviously the usual trucks, the usual hospitality units can't make the trip across, so everything is crated across in cargo, and that's why as a result we have a slightly different feel to the paddock. You can see the offices to the left hand side here, and the trucks themselves, or not the trucks, sorry, the garages, the boxes themselves are all pretty makeshift, because of course they have to pack all of this down ahead of heading to Thailand next weekend. I was just going to squeeze through here and try not to interrupt BT Sport, who are live at the moment. Hope it's going well, gents. Little wave from Neil and Susie. Of course, tuning in, if you're back in at home in the UK, you can listen to those guys. But just wait for me to finish first. And unfortunately, I'm going to be in the back of their shop, but I can't help it because I need to go here to LCR. I'm just looking to see if Lucio is around. And at the moment, no. Let me just bob my head in and see. There is Vicky, the wonderful Vicky. Hola, ¿qué tal? And here he is. Thank you very much, Vicky. Lucio, good news. I've got an umbrella, don't worry.
Hi, how are you?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
Well, we just received good news from the chief medical doctor. Taka has been declared fit just right now, because yesterday, when on Thursday, he has been declared to be reviewed. Also yesterday again to be reviewed, but now he's fit. So they give us the total permission to race.
That's fantastic. Obviously, great that he can ride anyway, but in particular here as well, not being in Japan for 3 years, so I'm sure he was absolutely desperate to get the opportunity to race in front of his home fans.
Exactly. It's incredible, because I didn't expect. Already yesterday was plenty of fun. This morning, despite the raining, there was a lot of crowd in the grandstand. So how to, you know, to not do our best to have a Japanese rider in the MotoGP class competing. So we are happy.
Yeah, it's incredible. The fans yesterday, did you see it? The fan show yesterday evening, they all had their lights. It was quite remarkable. As Taka walks through here, we'll be able to see that right hand there. Taka, all okay?
Well, yeah, a little bit pain than yesterday, but better than, the condition is wet and, you know, a little bit less force on the braking. So let's see in this afternoon.
Rest up, get some ice on it, and hopefully we'll see you in qualifying.
But I want to say that the best spectator yesterday was a beautiful dog with our
yes,
polo shirt on it. Have you seen it?
Yes, yeah, it was on social media. MotoGP put an Instagram reel out. If you've not seen it, go check it out. With the sunglasses on, right?
Yeah, this is fantastic. So they are really, really, really crazy fun, and for LCR, for Taka, and yes, of course we are very pleased.
Have you got any dogs at home?
Of course, I have a Shih Tzu, and also I have a cat with my girlfriend, and yes, we enjoy very much.
Well, I hope that we're going to see some photos of your Shih Tzu with some sunglasses on.
Yeah, we do have motorcycle sunglasses, and now we are building a special seat to bring the dog with us in the motorcycle and in the Vespa. You know, I have an old Vespa from the 80s.
Lucio, there is nothing in the world I want to see more than you on a Vespa with your Shih Tzu on the front of it.
You will see. I'm finishing to restoring it.
Okay, I look forward to it. Instagram is the place to see it. Just on the opposite side of the box, quickly before you go, Alex, these conditions should suit him. We saw in Le Mans in 2020, he was extremely fast, despite the difficulties that Honda have had this year. Is this a weekend where we could potentially see him further up the field?
Well, you know, in the wet condition, there are many things that change, you know. The bike chassis is not so important anymore. It's more about the feeling, it's more about the riding style, it's more about the feeling of the rider. And Alex is extremely, you know, is extremely fine, you know, how is extremely delicate how he ride the bike, and this helped very much, you know, to arrive at the edge of the grip on the wet condition. And yes, so far is he's in his career, he always performed quite well, so finger crossed for not heavy rain and for having Alex going in Q2.
Fingers crossed. A big weekend for you. I hope it goes to plan. But great to hear that Taka will be in the race tomorrow. Thank you, Lucio.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Great to speak with Lucio, as always, as we'll just let one of the HRC technicians behind us walk through. And yeah, I mean, the biggest thing to take away from that, obviously, Taka Nakagami, thank you, Vicky, fit and can ride in his home Grand Prix. Amazing news. But let's just get to the main point here. Lucio Cecchinello has a Shih Tzu at home, and he's working to modify his Vespa. Alex, all good, all good. Quick wave. He's working to modify his 1980s Vespa so he can put his dog on the front of it with some sort of racing goggles on as well. I mean, if you at home don't get excited by that, then I don't know what will get you excited. Just the mere thought of it is making me laugh. And hopefully, in Valencia maybe, we can see Lucio making a trip down from Italy to Valencia on his 1980s Vespa, which would be quite something. But yeah, on a serious note, great news that Taka is fit, and you can see the weather conditions here, far from improving. I think potentially the fact that it is wet will help him in that regard with that injury on the right hand. Of course, the fact that he doesn't have to push as hard certainly helps, as both Aaron Canner and Dennis Foggia stroll through the paddock. But to the same degree as well, obviously, in these conditions where you can find standing water, there's more possibilities for the bike to get out of shape when you're not particularly expecting it, which, of course, could jar that right hand. But you heard from Taka himself, a little bit better than yesterday. Certainly, it was still a grimace there. So fingers crossed he can get it iced up before MotoGP free practice 3, half an hour of that coming up your way, followed of course by Q1 and Q2. Here we are outside the box of the world champion. Is that a little bit of pizza there that they're tucking into? In fact, I'm going to swing round here and I'm going to see if I can get a slice of pizza from those guys. 1 second. Here we go. I'll let these guys come and join me as well, because if there's some pizza on offer, I definitely want to get involved. I might have to do something with the umbrella first. As Christian Pupelin, Jack Miller's crew chief, walks past. And this is a bit of a sneak attack, actually. But if there is a slice of pizza going, then I definitely want some. Here we go. Right, I'm going to put the umbrella down here, and I'll pick it up later, and I'm going to dive in and see, is there some pizza going, gents? I could smell it a mile off. What have we got going here? Oh, look at this, lads. Look at this. Is it pepperoni or just margarita?
Margarita.
Margarita.
Italian style.
And whose pizza is it? Whose is it?
No, it's good.
Can I take a slice?
Why not?
Do you mind? Take a slice? Is that okay? Is this Japanese style? Here we go. Lovely. Thank you. Cheers to everyone. Right, let's head back outside. Courtesy of the world champion. Thank you very much, Fabio. Oh, it's not bad, actually, as well. It's quite nice. Grazie. Lovely. Right, now I need to work out how to pick up the umbrella. Oh, we could be in a bit of difficulty here. Right, 1 second. Oh, there we go. Some of the Japanese fans there. All incredibly dressed as ever, the full mask on there. You're able to see lots of stuff on social media. Make sure you're following us on Instagram and Twitter as well, as we see all kinds of just incredible designs and outfits. The Japanese fans have had 3 years to work on their special outfits for every rider throughout every class as well. I was running the circuit yesterday and staggered at the fact that I've seen Andrea Mino, Celestino Vietti, Philip Salach, Tayo Furusato, Mario Adji, you know, flags specifically designed and created for riders up and down the MotoGP, Moto2 and Moto3 grids. Absolutely superb. The dedication from these Japanese fans is something we have definitely missed. Right, we'll just head further down this way. And also, yeah, I know that I'm still holding on to this slice of pizza here. Maybe it was a bad idea, but my hands are totally full. I would put the microphone down, but it'd be pretty boring just watching me eat a slice of pizza. I'll wait until we're done to finish that off, just to see if there are any other riders just floating around at the moment. It's nice to see. Konnichiwa. Great to see them all here. As Pekko walks past, let me just run. Pekko. 1 second. Pekko. Just quickly. No, he's gone. He's gone. He's gone. He's not having it. Just a quick question. Just quickly. How was this morning? All okay?
That's all good. We had to work a lot.
Okay. I'll let you get to work then. Thank good. You. I got it from Yamaha. It's not the best. I don't think you'd be impressed. It's not full Italian style, but...
Okay.
They
can try.
I will try it anyway. I'm sure the Catty's pizza would be slightly better. Right, okay. We've had a chance to chat with Pekko. That'll do me. We've spoken with Lucio as well. As you just wait for Jack to finish off here with some fans, I'll grab a quick word with him before he dives in as well. Oops, sorry. The Japanese fans are just asking me to get out of the way of their photo. Apologies. There we go. Once Jack has just finished off his conversation, I'll just ask him how he was this morning. In fact, whilst I'm not on camera as well, good opportunity to have another bite of this slice of pizza. But Jack was actually inside the top three this morning. It was topped free practice two by Marc Marquez. Surprise, surprise in these conditions. With Jack up there again, another surprise, of course he was. Plus Jorge Martin actually as well, which was a bit of a surprise. You know, not too much track time. Oh, good. Nice little gift.
Yeah. You want to smell these?
Oh, mate, they are grim. They are grim. I've got a slice of pizza as well from Yamaha. Not full Italian style, but...
No, I don't mind the Japanese pizza, to be honest. They've been heating it up down there, and I reckon the Italians could learn a thing or two. Nah, I'll get bagged out for that. I'll get bagged out for
that. If those Ducati lads hear that, they won't be particularly happy.
I'm enjoying the Japanese pizza. Enjoying Japan in general, apart from this weather.
Well, you say that, but this is a bit of you.
I don't know. No one likes riding around in this stuff. You know, it's just grim and boring and constantly on edge, so hopefully the sun comes back.
Fast this morning, though. Looking forward to qualifying.
Yeah, felt all right this morning. The bike's working really well, so we'll give it a crack, see what we can do come quali. See what this weather does. You know, there's a lot of standing water this morning. It was kind of sketchy, but... just in the little bits where it sort of dissipated a little bit, it was able to sort of semi-dry out, at least less standing water, and the bike was working well. So either way, I think we're going good this weekend, and hopefully we can get a decent quality result and turn that into a decent result on Sunday.
Top man, good luck. What do you know what the gift is, by the way? Should we give it an open?
Some.
Let's have a look.
You're more curious than me.
I know, I just want to know what it is. Live on MotoGP's social channels, here we go. This is like...
Sammy, how was it? Happy enough?
Look, yeah. So here we
chocolates.
Go. Ooh, look chocolate. At them.
Should be right.
Not bad.
Yeah, we'll get into them later on.
Yeah. Treat yourself after exactly. qualifying. Exactly. And make sure...
Delicious.
Yes.
This
one?
What are these? Are these special Japanese treats?
Japanese chocolate.
No. Special cookies.
Cookies.
Okay. Maybe, I think you like it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Very kind. Lovely stuff. Enjoy. And make sure you do something with them socks as well. They're absolutely disgusting. So there we go. I will now, in fact, do I really fancy another bite of pizza? Well, in fact, yeah, give me it here. I need to have another bite of pizza because all I can taste at the moment is Jack Miller's feet, which is absolutely disgusting. Thank you. Do you want a bite? He says it's not Italian. I know the Ducati guys won't be happy. So there we go. Very nice. The taste of Jack Miller's feet now officially out of my mouth. And that's about it from inside the paddock in Motegi. They do tell you that it's extremely rude to speak with your mouth full. So I'll stop and say goodbye. Thanks for joining us. We'll catch you in a week's time, Friday in Buriram. We'll see you there.